You go first.
You know, first of all, let me preface everything by saying I love this final tour for Kobe. I like seeing how every arena is handling it.
Yeah.
I think he deserves it. In a weird way, because I was there at Madison Square Garden when a young Kobe tried to take on Michael in the All-Star game. I know you were there too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And his whole career, from Kobe sounding like Michael to trying to play like Michael, patterning his moves after Michael.
Yeah, everything.
Kobe does not need validation, certainly from not me, from anybody. I think he's one of the greatest players of all time. But I feel like last night when he saw that video,
yes,
and Michael said all those things, that was kind of validation for Kobe. I just saw that look in his face, and it just looked like, I was a little surprised because that video was really long.
Yeah.
And Michael was very gracious, and I just felt like, you know what? That was validation for Kobe a little bit.
Yeah, I think he needed this, personally. I like the tour. I like what they're doing, giving the love. I think personally he needs this tour because Kobe has been in a love half, well, a quarter love, three quarters hate relationship, yeah, throughout everybody outside of Los Angeles. And he's felt that everywhere he's gone. And to see him now getting the love that he never probably thought he had, I think he needs this. But more than anything, I'm with Om on this. It took him a long time to get to this point where you get Michael Jordan's respect at this level. You know, there'll be other players retired. Tim Duncan's gonna go, Kevin Garnett's gonna go, Paul Pierce is gonna go, you know, we're gonna see them all. I don't know if they're gonna get this when they show up to Charlotte.
Yeah.
This is the validation that I think Kobe can, like we said earlier, Kobe's like, drop the mic, I'm done. I can stop, this could be my last game, I'm done. I'm all good. I think this was his, I'm all good. My cycle is complete, my career is over. This is really all I wanted, is to get this type of response and this type of public respect from the guy that I really didn't want to be like, but I chased. And, you know, Kobe did a movie, Kobe's Muse. You know, Michael was really his muse, because that's the goal he set for himself. So to get that, this is the culminating moment of his entire career, as far as I'm concerned.
So
you can see it by the look on his face. Yeah. And if you know Kobe, you know this is, yeah, I'm good now.
So you two clearly think that MJ really did this wholeheartedly.
I think so. I think the relationship is built up
over
the years.
Like, it wasn't just because...
No. Michael could have... Look, Michael's not in the game of playing games.
No.
He doesn't have to do anything.
Are you that big a cynic, Prim?
No, I was just asking. I'm here to stir the pot. I think it was very wholehearted.
Kobe said it.
Kobe
said
it. His farewell tour.
He said it on his press conference. Who did he call to talk about this?
Look, I'm sure...
I called Mike, and Mike is the one that's talked him through doing this, so yeah.
I'm sure Mike and Kobe talk quite a bit, and I'm sure Mike has said some of this stuff to him in private conversations before, just like you said. For Kobe to have this public now, for Michael to go out, take this step, Michael, he doesn't need to be bothered for something like this, right? He didn't have to do that.
Nope.
He didn't have to. He could have just taped basically a 30-second message. Congratulations, wish you nothing but the best, Kobe. You've been great. No. Michael went the extra yard, yeah. I felt like, in this video. The one thing I just kind of feel, there's a lot of people who think Kobe might be the greatest player of all time. A lot of people were hoping that he would win another championship so that he would be the greatest player of all time. I think all that tells you about this was that Kobe's face, when it happened, it shows you that Michael still is the greatest player of all time, because, like I said, Kobe looked like he wanted that validation, and he got it.
So Kobe will always be Kylo Ren, not Darth Vader?
He will not be Darth Vader, no.
Have you guys seen the new Star Wars?
Yes, I have.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you, some of the pictures you paint remind me of this. Kobe's Kylo Ren trying to live up to this image of his, in this case, grandfather, right, but perfect image of evil dictator, emperor.
Yeah.
He wasn't emperor, I understand. Please, Star Wars fans, don't attack me. It's good, but you know what? It's okay to be Kylo Ren. It's okay
unless you're going to get your butt whipped in a lightsaber duel. I don't want to spoil.
We don't want to ruin
it. I don't want to spoil it either.
But, you know, it's funny. You talk about the look on Kobe's face, and a little bit I think you can look at that and go, why did you want something so shallow? You know, why? Couldn't you be confident enough in yourself that you don't need to relish in it? But no, it's okay to want respect from those that you respect so greatly. And in this case, the greatest basketball player of all time.
Yeah.
I mean, we all search for respect. We all search for respect from people that we respect. Not necessarily on this and on social media, but from people that we respect. And Kobe held Michael in that regard, as he should. Fashioned himself as a player, like Michael. I'm going to will my team to victory. Yeah. It's going to be about me. Yeah. We're going to win or lose on me. It's not the Tim Duncan style, not the Dirk style, the Michael style, the Jordan style.
Exactly.
And to get that, as you point out, to get that validation from Michael, That's nice. It is a nice moment. Well, and I do think Michael's legit, even though he said, which I've never heard it phrased this way, I'm like your big brother. Yeah. Usually it said, you're like my big brother.
Yeah. Right.
So it's a little, well, still Michael-focused.
But Scoop, I did want to ask you something. Do you think now, when LeBron retires, is Michael going to do the same thing for LeBron?
That's I would have to think so. Good question.
It depends on the relationship Michael and LeBron have. I think Kobe and Michael have developed a relationship over the years that made Michael feel comfortable in doing this and felt that he, you know, understanding Kobe's situation, needed this to be said.
I mean, I think they definitely have a relationship.
Yeah, but I don't know if it's that to that degree. I don't think that if when LeBron retires or he gets to that point that he wants to retire, if he's going to be reaching out to Jordan for advice. I think LeBron is, I got this, I'm going to do it.
MJ set a precedent here.
But can I say, you pointed out?
Yeah. Not everybody gives
because if he doesn't give LeBron the same respect, then...
But you pointed out what Michael Jordan did here was go the extra mile. He didn't just do like a 30-second congratulations video. And the extra mile, I think what you're referring to is, you're like me. It's that simple sentence. You remind me of me. You're like me. And for Jordan to compare anyone to himself, that's the esteem. The truth is, LeBron is great. I think LeBron is the best player in the NBA. But he's not like Michael. They're not the same kind of players. Yeah. So Michael wouldn't necessarily be able to give that same extra mile that you point out.
And then, you know, you watch the whole video. When I said Michael was sincere, I don't think he wasn't reading that from
cue.
You could tell he was like really saying that off the top of his head.
And I think the relationship, once again, to the relationship of those two, I think Michael understands that LeBron didn't have to go through what Kobe went through. Mm-hmm. See, Kobe, the one problem Kobe has is that he came in too close behind Michael. We had just seen Kobe before Kobe. Like, Magic was compared to Magic Johnson when he first came in, but there was a distance. You know, between Magic and Michael. There was a difference between Kevin Durant and George Gervin. There was no distance between Michael and Kobe, and that's why Kobe caught a lot of hate, because it was so directly linked to Michael, and Michael knows that. LeBron doesn't have that, so Michael, I don't think, will feel compelled to have to do that for LeBron, because you didn't have to go through 14 years of your career living under my shadow. Kobe did, and to kind of release that from you, here's my gift.
Well, Kobe did catch a lot of hate, too, for running Shaq out of town, too, and how he reacted when he was with Shaq, too.
Oh, yeah, but once again, that was an L.A. thing. You know, and I think Kobe did some things off the court that kind of twisted it against him. But I think just coming in, he had that thrown on him immediately, and it almost, he came victimized by it. And I think Michael understood it, because Michael heard it.
Yeah.
Michael, and I'm pretty sure in the conversation they've had over the years, they have had that conversation.
I mean, think about how many next Michael Jordans where they're supposed to be.
Yeah,
you know?
But they all came and went.
All these guys,
Kobe
was the closest one
to
it.
And he kept it all along, and that's more than pressure, right?
And the reason Jordan doesn't have to do it for LeBron is LeBron was never the next Michael Jordan.
Right.
He was always the first LeBron James.
Right.
I think he will do it for LeBron. It might be just like a 17-second video. But the one thing that I think about is, you know, Michael Jordan is Michael Jordan, but we've all been in front of the camera and we're doing, you know, some hits on TV. Do you think he did that twice or three times and he was like, nah, wait, you know what? Let me say that. Let me do that again. Let me do that.
That was one take. Mike did it one time. That's it.
Mike. I mean, it is MJ. All right, let's wrap that up. Coming up, the Carolina Panthers' undefeated season has come to an end, but it is still only one loss.